Hi, this is more about a guy's intentions. How can you tell if a guy likes you or if he just wants a fling? Well, you don't know right away, and he may not know right away. That's the trick. He may not know. He may be a good guy, not trying to fool you, but actually holding back because he's afraid that you're gonna take it too seriously if he opens up and really, you know, gives you what he wants. All of these things really happen in dating. We mistake a guy's words for the truth, when actually he's saying things just because he knows you want to hear it. There's all kinds of things that happen that aren't true. And the most important thing that you can do is be true yourself. This means you say the truth to him. I want a real relationship. I'm not looking for a fling. So I'm going to hold off on sex a little while, just until I feel comfortable. That's going to stop a guy who just wants to have sex with you right in his tracks. You want to be truthful. On the other hand, you want to stay open and really kiss him, make out with him. Go as far as you feel comfortable. Let him touch you where you feel comfortable before you know yourself well enough that you would get to a point where you start to feel emotionally attached, that it has gone so far sexually and physically and emotionally that you are going to care whether or not he's a fling. That's pretty much a secret. That is a secret of how to protect yourself by not shutting down, but just by stopping and saying, oh, I'm starting to feel really involved here. I kind of want to just hold back a little bit until I know where we're at, because, you know, I'm looking for a real relationship, not a fling. I'll tell a story. I actually dated two guys at one time, and one guy I was having a physical intimacy fling with because I knew that I did not want to marry him because he did not want to have children. I absolutely did not feel emotionally involved with him to the point of pain because I knew I wanted to have children, and he was something I was learning from, and he was wonderful, and he was just great. And then there was another guy who wanted to have a fling with me, and he was straight forward about that, and I dated him, but him I felt attached to on the second date. He was like, yeah, that's my husband, that's the guy I want. And I was having a conversation with him about, no, I can't do that because I don't want to get involved with you because I could really care for you. I actually do really care for you. And that honesty made me feel powerful. It made me feel so confident. I met my husband soon after. It made me feel confident because I was saying the truth. I was being super brave in a way I had never been brave before. I was saying no to a guy for the truth. I didn't say, no, no, this is not what I want. You're this, you're that, you're just trying to play. No, I said, you know, I want this and you want that. I can't get involved. But the other guy was saying, you are giving me so much energy and so much love and so much fun that I know I am going to be the one who says no to you because I want to have children. And I'm going to continue to be open to a man who wants to have children. And in walked my husband. So I'm here to tell you that it's that honesty that will basically be so much better than armoring yourself. It'll be like this wonderful soft buffer for men where you feel powerful and you tell them the truth and then they say the truth. And you never have to worry about whether he likes you or whether he's just there for a fling. And that's how you tell if a guy's there for a fling, even if he does like you. Because he is going to like you, but he may not have intentions for forever, right? So hold back on what you know makes you involved and say the truth. To get more relationship advice, check out this video next.